So, the good news. I think I saw my husband, and he was just in a meadow, leaping around, like dancing, but like a butterfly. And I'm like, what? So that's where he went. He's just a butterfly, a gribliadi. My gosh, what took him so long to become a gribliadi? Is my question. Because I was one years ago. 5, 6, 7 years ago. What took him so long to get there, to that stage in his life? I mean, is it the age factors, because I'm older, that he found himself, that to relax finally, and maybe there was something there that I could relax right away, you know, because I was painting all the time, painting, painting, painting. And I'm like, I know there's some super nebula here from space, and I know it's just come and washed over us. So if this is all going on, and I'm dancing around like a gribliadi all around Corsica, why isn't he? And then all of a sudden, I spy him off in the distance. And then I'm like, well, what if that wasn't him? You know, what if that was someone else? But my mind is like, uh-uh, that was him. I know it was him. And if I saw it as him, and then, well, you know, maybe I can shoot that connection to him wherever he is, that he is still able and capable of being young and dexterous and amble, yeah, just able to have that freedom, that unadulterated freedom, that pureness of poet. It is a poet. It's to be that pure poet without the criticisms, without the self-consciousness, without the mundane Roman warrior walks and talks and jobs and lifestyles, you know. The fact that he's still capable of that freedom just gave me wow, you know. So beautiful, beautiful for me, because I needed a present, and that was a present. So, yeah, because I'm like, where is he? Where is he? And there he was. And I'm in my swimsuit, you know, I'm swimming. So I saw him out the window. Anyway, love to him. Love to him.